Finally, I ask you to consider third by doing it than respect. Show respect on a daily basis to everyone you interact with.
Stand up. Yeah.
Your co-workers and customers, your global partners and your local communities, your supporters and your detractors, and especially to those less powerful whose work can sometimes go unnoticed. As leaders, you will often get more credit than you deserve. Be sure to share this credit by giving respect to all who contribute to any success. Let me, in that same spirit, take a moment to thank every member of our Harvard Business School community, faculty and staff, both those who work front stage and those who work backstage, who have collectively helped to educate you and bring you to this wonderful moment of graduation. Please join me. As you commence life ahead, one of the specific challenges you will face is balancing the demands of your career with the rest of your life. In this arena in particular, I urge all of you to respect your loved ones as the number one priority in your lives. Tom DeLong, one of our senior faculty, uses a metaphor from the world of auto racing to describe a trap we risk falling into. In auto racing, the goal is to run as many laps as quickly as you can. Then, when it's time to refuel and put new tires on the race car, the driver pulls off the track to make a pit stop. In racing, one of the keys to victory is making quick pit stops. In other words, the goal of racing is to spend as little time off the track as possible. As you begin careers that will be challenging and even informing, some of you may fall into the trap of treating your own lives like the racetrack and your home like the pit stop. If you remember nothing else I say to you today, please remember this. Resist that trap. No matter how successful you are in your career, you will never be happy unless you are respecting your loved ones with the gift of your time, your presence, and your full attention, even if it requires you to step away from work at times that are inconvenient. As each of you think about the best ways to respect the people who are important in your lives, I'm sure your thoughts will immediately turn to the family and guests who are celebrating with you as you graduate today. So members of the class of 2017, let's take a moment to show this respect. Please stand up. Turn around. As much as today is a celebration of you and what you have accomplished, none of it would be possible without the strong support you've received from others. The husbands, wives, partners, parents, sisters, brothers, aunts, uncles, cousins, and friends who nurtured you and encouraged you. Maybe it was one special individual behind you, or a team. Maybe it was simply someone who believed in you early on. So join me once again in recognizing them and showing them your respect. Okay, turn back around. The faculty and I join your families, friends, and well-wishers in congratulating you on all you have accomplished during your time with us. We celebrate you and we wish you good luck as you begin your next adventures. We encourage you to be mindful of your responsibility as leaders at a time when business must work to rebuild the public's trust. We remind you to reach toward ambitious goals that will help solve society's most pressing problems. And we ask that you respect the people who are most important in your lives and everyone with whom you interact along your road to leadership. Remember, nothing can be accomplished without the help of others. As you begin this exciting new chapter in your lives, I wish you all the best and hope to welcome you back again and again to Harvard Business School.
Narayanan, and it's my pleasure to call the graduates forward to receive their degrees. We will now present the diplomas to the joint degree candidates for Master of Business Administration and Doctor of Medicine from the Harvard Medical School. Would Professor Carl Kester and our MD-MBA graduates please come forward?
Can you see anything?
Can you, James?
Can you?
Yeah, I can see that.
Good. The screen.
It's nice to have the screen.
Yeah.
Joseph Anaya. Christiana Beveridge, distinction.
Philosophy in Business Economics, Doctor of Philosophy in Health Policy,